Hello friends and welcome to our show Liz Talk. Today we have with us an eminent personality who was born on 1st January 1939, Mr. K.D. Gupta, Dr. K.D. Gupta. He is the chairman of ASSOCHAM, National Council on Climate Change. Welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, can you please tell us something about global warming?
Yes. Richa, I think this global warming these days, you hear from everyone, from every country. So the question is, this global warming is the result of what? Global warming is the result of industrialization, which started in 18th century. When the industrial development started and it picked up the speed, and everybody is trying to chase up, I want to set up industry. Resultant, urbanization. Because we have to live in cities, and then this is taken as a prestige point, that we convert the villages, small cities, into big cities.
Big cities.
Now, these are the two factors, to my mind, responsible for this global warming. Global warming is the result of emission of greenhouse gases, means CO2, carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is one of the six gases which is prominently now available. It is responsible for global warming. It increases the heat, and when this increases, then it affects the climate which we are seeing now. Now it is 1% Celsius, and when it is going to increase, there will be widespread impacts of this, because when this global warming will be increasing, it will melt, you know, the South and North Pole. It will melt the glaciers. Glaciers are the source of rivers, and this South and North Pole, you know, the sea level water will go up, and the result will be these small islands, the coastal cities will submerge in the water.
We might go back to the Ice Age.
Ice Age will be later on. Right now, this global warming is very permanent. Now, what is the reason? You see, the progress means everybody is trying to chase progress, not realizing what cost. If you are going to add to this industrialization and you are chasing that progress, but at the cost of nature, this is going to bounce back, and this is happening everywhere you hear. See, take all countries, no country is, you know, spared from this. Sometime back, Sandy storm which came in America, it is destroyed everything in 2 days. Then there was tsunami, you know, the Japan, you heard, you saw that situation. It came recently in Philippines, completely wiped off. It came to wiped off. So the resultant impact of this is very serious. So when the climate will be talking now, is will be the result of only global warming. 2% Celsius temperature will be there of the world. I have told you what happened. When glaciers will melt, the rivers completely dry up. The rivers are the source, because all civilizations developed, you know, along the rivers. You have heard that Mohenjo-daro Harappa, that was 5,500 years before, and it disappeared. So I was talking about that Mohenjo-daro Harappa. So that civilization developed along the river, which was called Saraswati. Now Saraswati is no more. That river disappeared, the civilization disappeared as a result of climate change. Because that Saraswati river is no more, it was one of the three, you know, rivers which were meeting at Allahabad, which we call Sangam. Now the third river is not there, only you see Yamuna, you see the river. Now out of these three, one disappeared. The another one, Yamuna, you have spoiled to that extent that it became only Nala, is no more, is a drain. Is all smelling, bad smell thing, you see. What is the result of this? How this has happened? This has happened because of the big cities. You know, when the Yamuna enters Delhi, 22 drains drop into this. And yes, there is no original water. This is all drain water, which we see there. So is going to happen with the Ganga. And now there was a result of the United Nations Council on Climate Change, they said after some time the rivers will disappear. This is going to be
very serious.
Yeah, very serious. What happened to Saraswati? So similar thing will happen to these rivers, because the main source of water is the glaciers, and supported by the rainfall. So the rainfall, because that so much of silt is there, that the water flows down the and goes to the sea. You can't stop it, because we are not thinking about, we are not planning seriously that what will stop. When if there is no water, it will have impact on your agriculture. So, which is a source of security, this will not be there. You will not be getting enough cereals, then pulses, and then you know, we call that oil seeds. And if there is no agriculture, proper agriculture, then there will be no fodder for the animals, and you won't get milk also. So the question is that all this is going to happen, and it is all linked up with this. Now recently, what is happening? You see that there is a rainfall. It's not stopping. It was not expected. Every year it takes place, November to December, at most.
So you are talking about the April season that we don't have. It's an awkward.
It's very awkward.
Weather we are facing.
It's
we
very
don't
awkward.
Have
it's
rainfall
very awkward.
This
is unusual.
Very unusual.
It's not natural, and it's.
How is it affecting our agriculture?
You see that still that crop is in the field. The farmers have not been able to cut it. And if they cut it, that it will be spoiled. The rainfall, rain will stop. In Maharashtra, you saw that the storm, they completely spoiled, and the farmers are committing suicide because of. I mean, they feel very.
The price will also go up.
Yeah, very much. When there is a the food getting in short supply, the price has to increase. The prices of the vegetables will increase. The price of the fruits will increase. Why? Because fruits are spoiled also. Mango crop will be bad this year.
Very bad.
Very bad. So the question is that we have to think about that the sources of global warming is the energy. You know that electricity is required for industry, for houses, everywhere. You require for agriculture also. You require
for everything.
Yes.
Our life is.
But we don't realize from where the electricity is coming. This is coming. 70% electricity is coming from thermal power station, and these thermal power stations are coal based. You see that.
The natural.
No, because you can't do otherwise. Gas is not to that extent available, and we have not set up enough number of gas-based, you know, thermal power stations. And hydro power stations are very much, you know, because people are against that. They don't want. You have recently, in the recent past, you heard that people were saying Abiral Ganga. They were against these dams. You see that.
Yes.
So the question is that they saved you. I'm an energy economist. I understand that what is the importance of the dams, you know, for us.
So what is your organization doing to control the global warming?
We are trying to, first of all, awareness. If I tell you that this global warming or climate change will be due to these reasons, so then you will be cautious. You will take up this thing. I always take it that it's a human greed, and human this that I want progress, but I don't know at what cost I am doing this progress. You know, one side you are building industry, building big roads, cutting trees. The other side, you know, these big cities are coming up. This one side, which is generating carbon dioxide.
Not getting good water to drink, not getting good vegetables.
You will not get water. Drinking water will be a very serious problem. And it is said that Third World War will be fought for water.
For water?
Oh yes, water.
There will be water everywhere, but not a single water.
No, there is 97% water is there in the sea. But it's not drinkable.
It's not.
The only 3% water is the potable. Is a sweet water.
Sweet.
On this,
which we are spoiling.
Every day, we lift water, then you can see that the ground level is of the water is going down, down, down. I mean, I recall when I came here, Noida, it was 60 feet below water was available. Now it is 100 feet. So from 1998. How many years? This is something like 16 years. So much 40 feet water has gone down, and it's not stopping. And we are not doing anything because we have virtually, removed these ponds and the water bodies completely. That the human being want to reclaim that land, construct the buildings on that. So we are not realizing what is the importance of the ponds for us.
So, as global warming, because of global warming, we are having climate change.
Mm-hmm.
So, what is the effect of climate change on our lives? Drastic effect.
Climate change, as I said, that it will have its impact on all aspects of human life. The, you know, agriculture produce will go down when this global warming increases. Then erratic rains, which you are seeing now. And then its effect will be on industry. Its effects will be on many other sectors, you know. So the question is that
how can we solve this climate change?
This means we have to have it now. We realize, let us realize that water should be developed at the rate of 10%, which is called GDP growth rate should be there, or should be balanced. Chinese have realized, they said that okay, let us bring down, go slow. There are many countries, you know, where this problem is not there. Our country is facing very seriously this problem. You are seeing that the cloud was last year on 16th of June in Himalayas. Before that, 2010, Leh, there was a cloud burst, and that in that belt, this cloud burst is very common now.
So as you did talk about cloud burst, so is it going to happen again in the future?
Certainly, because what is the reason for this?
How often will it going to happen again?
That rainy season will come.
Yes.
You know, because when the monsoon, it starts from the south, you know, Arabian Sea or the Bay of Bengal, it passes through the land mass. And wherever there is a greenery, they stop it. They catch it. But when there is no greenery, there is a houses, big, big multi-story building, they don't stop the clouds, you know. Because the clouds condense and rain. But if they don't condense and they pass by, then they go and where they stop? At the Himalaya.
At the Himalaya.
Himalaya doesn't allow them to go to other side. So when the lot of clouds are, collected in that place, and then it, a big layer of clouds is there, and
then
it condense and burst. It's just like you have lifted some big river and left at that place. 100 millimeter rainfall within an hour in a limited area is a cloud burst. So what happened on that day, 16th of June last year? 300 millimeter rainfall was there, and you have cut the trees. So the boulders were not supported by anything. No, there was no stopping them. So then there was a rainfall, it started rolling down and it destroyed.
Destructed and
yes,
destroyed.
Completely.
Whatever comes.
Yes. But our government did not bother. We are allowing these towns to go to the hilly areas without realizing what will be the effect. Because when you make the road, you cut the trees. And when you cut the trees, you see there is nothing to stop that landmass.
So, tell us five main factors responsible for climate change.
Okay.
Five main factors.
So, take it one is your that, you know, this rate of growth and industrialization, as I said, urbanization. And then to meet the human requirement, because the human population is increasing and you want to meet their requirement for lighting and for other purposes. So, that electricity which is coming from, thermal power stations. And the other side, you are cutting the trees without realizing that this carbon dioxide is absorbed by the trees only. They absorb for you, produce oxygen for you, which is we call it in Hindi, isn't it? So cutting of the tree and development of industry, urbanization, isn't it? And our broadening of road, because the roads are becoming now shorter, traffic jams. You
because
see?
Of the population.
Oh. The transport is also responsible. Now, if you just go back and see that we are contributing our industry, this electricity, this is contributing 43% carbon dioxide, greenhouse gases, 22% transport. Now, these two factors are very seriously contributing to this, and we cannot live without electricity. Now, there is a need to think about this, that let us have another renewable source of energy. The electricity should be generated in the countryside by utilizing locally available resources, not the centralized electricity we should use.
Yes.
For my point, this is very important for us. Solar energy is there, wind energy is there. This is to meet up, because sustainable growth will depend on these factors. So I said that industrialization, urbanization, and then cutting of the trees, and your modernization. Everybody, we are now also believing it. If that mobile, and when you produce a mobile, what happens?
Keeping a car, keeping a personal mobile.
You are using not that in the field, agriculture, that manure. You are using fertilizers, means urea and all that. This is manufactured from this, you know that, chemicals. They are chemicals. So they are spoiling your, when tree growth will stop, then you can take it on this planet. You will have the same situation as we have now. We see the Mars and we imagine and we say that, okay, there was some water availability here, but now nothing is available. So the day is not very far when this is going to happen. So it is the right time. It's a wake up call. All these calamities, you know, in all over the world, it's a wake up call. They are telling you, please stop this.
You have your conference recently on 5th March.
Yeah.
About this calamity. So what was the outcome of it? What was?
We have, in fact, we brought out the recommendations of that conference. We have circulated this, and they are very similar. What the United Nations United Nations ICC committee has given the recommendations. I can make available. I have given this copy to somehow. I can see that the recommendations are very serious. And the question is that the green energy projects to be taken up, to, you know, stop, not completely stop, but so that the mitigation efforts start, you know. So you require funds. The contribution to this climate change is from the developing nations.
How is Marva Studios contributing to your work, sir?
Marva Studio, you know, it has joined us. This was one of the media partner in that conference. Now we are going to celebrate on 22nd of April, that Earth Day.
Earth Day.
Yes. What is Earth Day? It is started.
World's Earth Day. The whole world's going to celebrate.
Yeah. All countries are doing this. Right now, more than 185 countries are celebrating
this Earth Day.
Yeah, Earth Day. And it started in 1970, and there were many more reasons.
Since then, we are celebrating
second
April.
Every year, this is being done. Now, the basic objective is that let us tell our children, they should understand that the planet, which is only one in this whole, our, what do you call the solar system,
where life is possible.
Yes. And we must, we call Mother Earth. We don't say that.
We don't have life
yes.
anywhere.
There
is the
no other earth than this earth, you see. So the children must be told, have a respect. The environment which we are spoiling, we will be damaging our own cause. So let us remember this.
Yes.
Every year we should the children make paintings. They save the earth, save water, save. Don't cut the trees. These are the things, you know. The children are now themselves coming forward. This. They will be taking the rallies, there will be competitions. All objectives behind is that people should be told that this is only single earth where we are living, and it shouldn't happen like, you know, you have heard that Kalidas was sitting on the same branch which was cutting. So
we
don't
are doing
do that.
Same. We are doing the same.
Yes. That's why I said it is a high time. Let us think about
realize
seriously,
this.
Realize this importance, isn't it?
And you should seriously work on it.
And it is said that we have not, inherited this earth from our ancestors. We have borrowed from our children. So you have to return to them, isn't it? You can't completely make hollow and create problems for them. So this is where precisely is a remembrance of this. Let the people realize its importance. I think.
So you've told us a lot of things about global warming and climate change, and how we should realize that it's the high time we should realize to stop doing bad things by, you know,
balance partially. You must balance.
Balance our lives.
No, I said it should not, you go on developing industry.
For our own personal interest, we are, you know, disturbing the whole humanity.
Yeah. But those people who are, doing for their benefit, they are putting the rest of the people in.
That's it.
Yes, very much.
In danger.
You see that? I mean, as I said, what happened in Japan, what happened in America, and what happened in Europe
will be in future also.
It will
very
not stop.
Often,
it
yeah.
will not stop. It will go on. So it should not go. We must not stop, but we must slow down.
Slow down.
We must balance it.
Balance.
Plant more trees. Don't cut the trees. Isn't it? Now, a simple example, you see that there were trees on both sides of the roads. That was by our Shesha Suri, you have heard the name. He planted these trees, you know, because he realized that people will be walking and there should be shade.
Oxygen.
Yes, yes. Now, what is happening that you want to, you know, widen the roads? You cut the trees. Why can't you do that? Leave the trees in the center, make the road on the other side.
On the other side.
So this serves, you know. Otherwise, the saying like, if I cut one tree, I'll plant 10 trees, this is no use. Because 50 years you will require that the services which the present tree is giving, these 10 saplings will grow to that extent and give you that sort of an advantage and service only after 50 years. So wait for that. Or don't cut the trees, plant more trees. You see that?
Sir, you are doing a great job service to the humanity. So thank you coming to our show. We are grateful to talk to you.
Okay, thank you very much.
Stay tuned with us, mavastudios.tv. Till then, bye-bye.